N95, ain't that like the mask?
Please wear your mask.
Hey, my name is Marco Aquila. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, even if you're not new, go ahead, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Y'all know I'm barely a YouTuber. Let's help this process along. Okay, so Kendrick Lamar just dropped another music video from his album, The Morale and the Big Stepper, called N95. Now, I think I did hear this song on the album because y'all know I just talked about it in the previous video. So I just had recorded a reaction for The Heart Part 5 when I noticed that N95 just released too. He is in his y'all finna get this content bag right now, and I'm here for it because y'all know I love the album. I love the album. I love the album. I love the Big Morale. It's giving really good to me. It's good. N95, ain't that like the mask? Ain't that COVID?
Please wear your mask. Wear your mask. It is very important for you to put on that mask.
I don't know. Let's honestly just jump right into the reaction. Let's not play. Let's go ahead and get into the thumbnail. Okay, so the thumbnail to me is giving very much so like, nan and a boo boo. Need to grow up. It's giving very much so. Nan and a boo boo. Bitch, I'm finna kill you. Bitch, I'm finna get. You finna get shot. You finna get shot. You finna get shot. That's what the thumbnail is giving me. Let's just go ahead, get into a review and see what the visuals in the video is giving. If it's anything like The Heart Part 5, I'm telling you, I might pass out right now because The Heart Part 5 was so good. Like, it was so simple but yet so effective, and like the AGI, like the face changes that he did. It really took me to a whole nother level, and I was ranting and raving because it just made me miss artistry. I'm not the biggest rap fan, but I am a fan of artistry, and his lyricism is literally unmatched. He literally is a storyteller, and I'm just ready to see. I don't know why, like, I always get nervous before, I'm always nervous beforehand. Let's see.
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls.
Oh my God, ain't that Moses?
You're back outside, but they still lie.
Whoa. I already need a break. Okay, so this one, I can already tell this is going to be more of a conceptual video versus the last one. How it was more like simple. This looked like it already got depth to it, and I'm not ready. Okay, let's go.
Take off the fufu.
Oh,
take
snap.
Off the couches, take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car loan. Take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird ass jewelry. I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off some fabricated streams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo. Take off the
Sanjo.
Pay 5 days stay. Take off for the meal. Hella final. Take off the far flag. Take off
the. Okay, just like in the other video, Kendrick is gonna give you like a little bit of a dance. So on this one, he giving more of a. Kendrick said. Okay, let me get back. Oh my God.
Take off the allure, take off the unsure, take off the decisions I lack. Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke, take off the I'm broke, I care. Take off the gossip, take off the new logic, that if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the shirt nail, take off the doje, take off the broken bag. Take all that good and bullshit off, and what do you have?
You ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Ooh, she's really pretty.
Who you think they cover up us?
Get back in pocket.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are banned, the law take advantage, the market is crashing,
this
the industry wants niggas and bitches to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watch it for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucked. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel.
Oh my God, that is so beautiful.
My sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change, you
miracle.
I know the feelings that came with burial cries.
Bitch, you ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Wait. Why he saying it so hard? You ugly as fuck. Kendrick. Wow, and see, this is, I'm already, okay, so I'm almost halfway through, and he already is, like, giving, like, this is when I say poetry, this is when I say storytelling. He is talking about a deeper message. Like, he is literally talking about, like, it's not surface level with him. And I think he's basically anti all the shit the rest of y'all favorite rappers talking about right now, because it's basically like, from what I'm taking so far, it's like, what are you when all of these expensive worldly possessions are taken away from you? You know what I'm saying? You don't have the Birkin bag no more. You know what I'm saying? You don't have any of these things that signify success, that signify beauty. What are you? Like, now what are you? According to Kendrick, you ugly as fuck. That's what he said. That's what he said. Don't quote. Don't get mad at me. That's what Kendrick said. Okay, let's get back.
I got nothing to lose. I got problems and pools. I can swim with my fate. Camera's moving.
I do got a question. Do you think when they be rapping like that, like, obviously they be changing their voice, but do you think that's uncomfortable? Let me learn the lyrics.
The family suing whatever I make. Murder is stacking. The president acting. The government taxing my funds in the bank. Homies ejecting the fence when I'm breaking. Look at my reaction. My pupils on skates. Hold up, hold up.
Let's think about this for a second. Tell me what you would do for steady. We show your show no credit. We show your bro for leverage.
What a hypocrite said. What community feel that the only one's relevant? What a hypocrite said. What community feel that the only one's relevant?
You out of pocket, yeah, you out of pocket. You entertain the mediocre, need to stop it. You entertaining old friends when they toxic. What's your life like, bullshit and gossip? What the fuck is council culture doubt? Say what
okay, I will say, okay, just a peek, just to speak off of the bar that he just said about what the fuck is council culture. Is it bad that, okay, I'm not gonna say I'm pro cancel culture, but I am definitely pro, like, if you do something wrong, you need to be held publicly accountable for it. Because I do feel like we're in a day and age where you should have known better. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm tired of the whole facade of, oh, teach me. At this point, and a lot of y'all big grown ages, y'all don't need to be taught some of the things that you should have unlearn. Like, you are, a lot of times, especially when it comes to like the LGBTQ community, especially when it comes to the Black community, especially comes with any disenfranchised group, it's kind of like, we shouldn't still really have to be teaching you anything, because you should know and understand that your logic, your hate, your disdain, your comments are not based in love. They're not based in acceptance. So why do you need to be taught that? Why do you need to be taught that the thing that you said was wrong? Yes, I do get everybody think that we're in a more like sensitive time, and we could be, but I think nothing is wrong with that. Like, I think for so long people were hurt, and we're just in a time where you're not finna just say shit to hurt me no more. You know what I'm saying? Now, the big cancellation of people is definitely, except for Daniel Caesar. Daniel Caesar is the one artist that really did get canceled, because don't nobody be hearing about him no more. Like, for real, for real. But realistically, canceling is, you really can't do that. Like, there's always going to be a subgroup of people who are still going to support you, and you're still going to get opportunities once you made it to, you know what I'm saying, a certain level. But, like, I don't know. I'm not pro cancel culture, no. Now, it do get a little outrageous. I'm just pro, you need to be held accountable for the actions that you did that were shitty. And you need to have to apologize for them publicly. And you need to educate yourself. I just hate that teach me line. You were too old. You 36. I'm not going to be teaching you about how you should be nice to people. Okay. That's my rant. Let's get back to the video.
About you niggas, I'm like overdog. I treat you crackers like I'm Jigga. Watch out, own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic that ain't protocol, bitch.
Ooh, I want a skateboard. I'm gonna follow though. Ooh, you gonna end it like that? This shit hard. Directed by Dave Free and Kendrick Lamar. Y'all, I'm not finna play on Kendrick's name at all. When I say that he is legitimately one of my favorite rappers, his concepts are so like out of it's almost unorthodox when you think of like rap. He almost the two are okay. So I do like Kendrick Lamar. I like Tyler the Creator too. I just like storytelling when it comes to my rap. You know what I'm saying? I like the depthness of it. But I will say you do have to be in a certain mood. Like if you're not in the mood to be hearing about real shit, like you're not gonna want to just listen to this, you know, casually, like for real, for real. But if you in that headspace and you just want to consume art and you want to consume, like, I would say something of substance, that is definitely a go-to for me. Y'all already, I don't think I even gotta say it. It's definitely getting added to the iPod. It's definitely a hit. It's definitely just like a lot deeper. And I definitely like this video because this was more of like that visual, or like that visual element that I felt like I wanted to see. You know what I'm saying? It gave story. It gave everything. In the comment section below, let me know what is your favorite song off of the new album and what y'all think about the video. I'll talk to y'all later.